The longest-running Broadway show in history first held auditions in 1971. Among the hopefuls was a teenage boy who was rejected. The note said, "Voice really weak. This guy's no actor." But when the hit show was made into a movie, it was that weak-voiced non-actor who starred in the picture. His number one record is coming up as an AT40 extra.
American Top 40.
Well, now on American Top 40, it's time for the first chart hit by a very popular young artist who dropped out of high school in New Jersey to become an actor. Got his father very uptight. So the kid promised he'd go back to school if he didn't make it as an actor within 1 year. Well, he got his first role in a summer stock production of Bye Bye Birdie. Then he moved to New York and worked in some TV commercials, studied dancing, and picked up some small roles in several off-Broadway plays. He got a featured part in the musical Grease, which led to more jobs, and guest shots on several TV shows. Finally, he was cast in a new TV series that became one of last season's big, big hits. And, ironically, it put him right back in a high school classroom. The TV show, Welcome Back, Cotter. He plays Vinnie Barbarino. Moving up to number 10 this week with his first hit, John Travolta.
The hit from coast to coast.
This is Mark Elliott for Casey Kasem. We're up to the latest hit by a very popular young artist who dropped out of school in New Jersey to become an actor, which made his parents very unhappy. So the kid promised his dad he'd go back to school if he didn't make it as an actor within 1 year. Well, he landed his first role in a summer stock production of Bye Bye Birdie. Then he moved to New York and worked in some commercials, studied dancing, and picked up some small roles in several off-Broadway plays. He got a featured part in the musical Grease, which led to more jobs and guest shots on several TV shows. Finally, he was cast in a new TV series that has become one of the most popular shows of the past 3 years. And it put him right back in a high school classroom. The TV show is Welcome Back, Cotter, and he plays Vinnie Barbarino. Well, what happened next to John Travolta's career is pretty familiar. Rave reviews for The Boy in the Plastic Bubble and his Oscar nomination for his starring role in Saturday Night Fever. His latest hit song is one of the tunes from the new film version of the musical Grease, in which he also stars. And here on American Top 40, he's up to number 6, along with his co-star from the film. Here are John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John, and You're the One That I Want.
American Top 40.
Well, now, my story about the actor once rejected by the longest-running show in Broadway history. It's a story that Jim Jacobs told me. Jim co-wrote and co-created the original production of Grease. And he said that a few weeks ago, rummaging through a closet at home, he found an old briefcase that contained his scribbled notes from the play's very first audition in New York. Each performer, as he remembers it, had 5 minutes to audition and impress the director, producers, and writers. And one of the hopefuls was a 16-year-old boy who auditioned, according to Jim's notes, on December 13th, 1971, around 4:30 in the afternoon. And here's what Jim Jacobs wrote about that young man. Quote, "Voice really weak. This guy's no actor. 86. End of quote. 86, of course, means toss him out. Now, as everyone knows, the play Grease went on to be very successful. And it eventually became the longest-running show in Broadway history, a total of 8 years. Over the years, Grease featured many unknowns who later became big stars, like Barry Bostwick, Treat Williams, Richard Gere, Jeff Conaway, and Rex Smith, and that 16-year-old boy who'd been rejected. He returned a year later to get a supporting role in the play, and then, when he was 23 years old, he starred in the smash movie version of Grease. He was the leading man opposite Olivia Newton-John. A long way from that audition where he was 86th. A long way for John Travolta. Thanks to one of the co-writers of the show, Jim Jacobs, for sharing his story with us. Now, as an AT40 extra, here's a number one smash from Grease, John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John with You're the One That I Want.
I got chills, they're multiplying, and I'm losing control, 'cause the power you're supplying, it's electrifying.
Casey's Top 40.
For Casey Kasem, I'm David Perry.
Now we're up to the song Grease Megamix. It's a medley of hits from a film that helped make actor John Travolta one of England's all-time most successful singers. Most of us know John Travolta for his roles in box office smashes like Saturday Night Fever, Pulp Fiction, and Phenomenon. But for a brief period in the 70s, John was also a moderately successful recording artist. In fact, he put out three solo albums between 1976 and 1978. Those albums gave John a few top 40 hits. But more importantly, they helped the actor land a starring role in one of the most successful movie musicals ever made, the blockbuster film Grease. When the soundtrack from the album Grease came out, it made John Travolta a big star on the music charts. But nowhere was he more successful than in England, where he scored four big hits within a span of 8 months. John had two number one duets with Olivia Newton-John, You're the One That I Want, and Summer Nights. And he had a couple of solo hits, Sandy and Grease Lightning. According to the Guinness Book of British Hit Singles, John's four hits combined spent 60 weeks on the British chart in 1978, more than any other act. 16 of those weeks, John Travolta was at number one in his duets with Olivia Newton-John, and that ranks as one of the longest one-year tallies of all time in England. In fact, only Frankie Lane and Elvis Presley have spent more weeks at number one in a calendar year. This week, a medley of three of John Travolta's hits from Grease is the biggest mover on Casey's Top 40, leaping eight notches to land at number 16. Here's John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John with the Grease Megamix.
Well, this car is automatic.
America's Top Hits. 4 years ago this week, one of the top hits in the USA was Change the World, the theme from a movie starring John Travolta as a man whose life is changed by a mysterious beam of light. The film has been one of the bright spots in the ongoing comeback of the star of Saturday Night Fever. In this case, John stars as a village simpleton who walks out into the street of his small town and is struck by a strange light from the cosmos. That light turns him into a genius, a man who can learn foreign languages in moments, who can solve impossible equations, who has a complete understanding of the human mind. A man who becomes, as the title of the film tells us, a phenomenon.
Countdown the hits.